What's good, y'all? It's Taj Rocket, aka Mr. Highly Motivated, baby. Here to get you motivated, baby. And we out here at Vacation Isle Park here in San Diego, California. And we here for Motivated Mondays, episode number 43. And I'm going to help you get your mind free today, because today what we're talking about is take imperfect action. That's right. I'm challenging you. I am asking you. I am requesting for you to take imperfect action on whatever you are looking to accomplish, whatever you are looking to create, whatever you are looking to do in your life, whether it is macro or micro. I am asking you, I am challenging you, I am requesting to have you take imperfect action. Now, the reason why I'm bringing this up is because procrastination is definitely something that I've struggled with, and I know that a lot of society as a whole, especially here in America, has struggled with as well. Now, in procrastination, what we like to do, we like to push things off and pretend like we're gonna get to it as we could right now. Now, the big thing about procrastination is, a lot of times with procrastination, it's a big task. It's a big task that we have at hand. Let's say it's like, I need to study for this huge exam tomorrow. So we got this big study block, and we knew that we pushed it off, we procrastinated it, and then we got this big thing that we got to study for and accomplish for the next day, right? Now, in the midst of procrastination, a lot of times, instead of just pushing it away and pretending like we're not going to be productive, we choose to do smaller activities and tasks like vacuuming, like wiping down the counters, like maybe taking the dog for a walk. Maybe you need to shave a second time or brush your teeth again. We find little tasks that are really irrelevant towards our goals, and we choose to do those instead of the bigger tasks like studying for that big test. Now, in terms of taking imperfect action, I challenge you to take imperfect action on everything, whether it is studying for that test. If you don't think you're fully ready, just put yourself in the situation, read one page. Read one page. I guarantee you that momentum from reading that one page, taking that imperfect action of just giving it a go, it will help turn into two, and then it will turn into three, and so on and so forth. Next thing you know, you'll be on a roll and you won't want to stop because you've created that flow. You've created that momentum. You've created that movement towards the goal, and that will give you more confidence to continue to pursue the goal. Now, in terms of, let's say, a relationship. Let's say you got a relationship and you're like, you know, my girl's mad at me, so on and so forth. I know I should give her a call more often. I'm just not mentally ready there. I'm telling you, a lot of people, especially in relationships, they prefer you to contact them, to reach out to them, to communicate with them, whether you're 100% ready or whether you're 100% able to give them 20,000 minutes or not. A lot of times, especially in a relationship, let's say you're worried about giving that person a call because you don't have enough time to hear their whole story or whatever. If you just give that person a call, shoot them a text, let them know that you're thinking about them, take that imperfect action, that individual will more likely than not be like, I'm so happy that you thought of me. I'm so grateful that you even took the time, even if it was 10 seconds, 30 seconds, a quick call like, hey, just wanna let you know I'm really busy. I was thinking about you, but I still wanna have a more in-depth conversation later, so on and so forth. All right, yeah, you have a great day. I'm gonna keep you on the top of my mind. I can't wait to talk to you later. Have a good one. Those individuals will take that small little action step, that small little piece, sliver of your time, they will take that and they will literally account for that as time that you made for them. And then, boom, you can check that box in a way. If you like to, you know, think of things in tasks, you can check that box and say, you know what, I did do the right thing, I did reach out to that person, so on and so forth. But if you take that imperfect action to reach out to the other person, they will know that you wanted to talk to them, you wanted to reach out to them, you wanted to be a part of them. Now, in terms of, let's say, your fitness, right? Oh, this is a big one. Fitness and nutrition, but let's start with fitness first. So with fitness, a lot of times, individuals, like let's say the new year. The new year is a big, big money time for all the gyms, all the trainers, all the supplement companies, all that stuff. Why? Because we prefer to put something like a big goal, like I want to lose 20, 30 pounds. I want to transform my body and my life, so on and so forth. We like to put those things off until a later date, because when we put that off, we are now not required to do anything until that date. We literally tell ourselves, no, I'm gonna wait until Monday. No, I'm gonna wait until January 1st. No, I'm gonna wait. I'm gonna wait until after Christmas. I'm gonna wait until after the holidays. I'm gonna wait until I turn 30. I'm gonna wait until I turn 40. And then what happens is we continue to push it off. And then when that date comes, the date's here, and we more than likely are not fully invested in it and haven't really given it the proper amount of attention that it deserved from that first day that you decided that you wanted that goal to happen. I'm telling you, take imperfect action. Something is always better than nothing. Think always something. I think that's a quote that I read in my precision nutrition book that I've been working on my precision nutrition course. And what I've learned is always something. Think something is always better than nothing. No matter who you are, no matter where you're at in life, always something is better than nothing. Like, let's say you're working out and you're like, oh, I'm not gonna make it to the gym today. 10 squats at the house are better than no squats at all. One walk around the block is better than no walks around the block. You know what I'm saying? Getting up and doing something is gonna get the blood flow. It's gonna help you with your energy and your productivity levels. It's gonna help you with your clarity in your mind. It's gonna help you create that momentum like I mentioned earlier. Let's say if you're studying, it's gonna help you go towards that goal. But if you continue to push it off and push pause, we love to push pause in society because when we push pause, we pause our obligations and our needs to be productive. We pause the feeling of I need to do something, or we push pause on something so we are no longer burdened by that thing that we actually wanted in ourselves and that we asked of ourselves in the first place. So what I found is a little bit that studying, you read that one page, right? The relationship, you're busy. You send that one little text, that acknowledgement. Let's say the fitness. You do that one squat, even just one squat. One squat, it'll turn into 2, 4, 8, so on and so forth, and it will continue to carry over. But if you don't take any type of action, more likely than not, eventually, when that time comes that you pushed off to the future, you're not gonna take any action at that point, or when you do, you'll fizzle off and then just reset another day. And then that just becomes a repetitive cycle of unaccomplishing tasks. And what it is us as humans, especially in this society, we think grand, which is great. I think the big picture, I wanna do this. I wanna conquer the world. I wanna start my own business and make $1 million. I wanna travel to every country, so on and so forth. I wanna put my mom in a $1 million mansion. Those are all amazing goals. I have those goals myself. But what I have found through my own trial and error is that when you make this big grand goal, it makes it easier because it's so far away. It makes it easier to put those little things, those little steps that get you to that goal, it's easier to put those away because you're already kind of making something that's not as realistic and attainable. You're making that harder to grasp. And so you make your everyday needs and goals harder to grasp for yourself. It's almost like setting ourselves up for failure instead of success. So what I found is if you take the action, the imperfect action, it doesn't have to be perfect. Let's say you wanna start a blog, put one video out today. Put that video out today. Let's say you're like, I wanna be a social media superstar, put that piece of content out today. And what you'll realize is there's growth in action. Action breeds growth, it breeds learning, it breeds you for time to reflect and to look at that in which you have done, and then that gives you the opportunity to be better. So let's say you put out a video for the first time in your life. You're gonna look at it, you're gonna be like, man, I wish I would've done this. Instead of deleting it and going back and beating yourself up, the next one that you make the adjustments that you notice you wish you would've made on the first one. And then the good thing is, when you look back on that first one, you'll be able to use that as a reference point. So when you see your future videos, let's say 5, 10, 20 down the road, you'll be able to see how much you've grown. You'll be able to see what you've done to become better. And the good news is, when you look years down the line, you're gonna love to see where you started. You're gonna love to, that's why progress photos with fitness are so big. People don't wanna take that picture. That's that small action. That's that imperfect action of you taking a picture of your imperfect self. Because first off, there is no such thing as perfection. Don't ever get that confused. Perfect is not real. We make this idea of perfect, but in reality, a lot of times the thing that we idolize, let's say it's a certain body type, let's say it's a celebrity, let's say it's a certain IQ, so on and so forth. The individuals that are attaining that perfect, they're not in your life. They don't have the same obligations. They don't have the same requirements. They don't have the same day-to-day tasks. And if they were in your shoes, they would realize that that perfect is actually not perfect. So I'm telling you, if you take these imperfect steps, like taking a selfie of yourself before you begin your fitness journey, and you just begin that day, you go, you know what? I'm taking a picture of today. I'm going to start doing 10 squats every day this week. Boom. What you're going to notice is when you take that next picture, let's say bi-weekly, I recommend bi-weekly. So you take another picture 2 weeks But you're consistently, every day, 7 days a week, doing something, always something, it's better than nothing. You're doing a little something, you will notice that those 10 squats will become so easy, you're gonna naturally have to do 20. Or you're gonna start adding in some lunges. Next thing you know, you're like, I gotta get some upper body. Then you'll add some push-ups, right? Then you'll add some dips. Now, I'm telling you, it is a trickle effect. You create the momentum for yourself to be successful. But if you don't take that imperfect action, that action will never happen, and that goal will never be accomplished. So you gotta understand that it's all in the action, it's all in the momentum, and none of us are perfect. So the action in which you're gonna take, even if you're quote unquote ready or not, is imperfect to begin with. So love your imperfect self, love your imperfect path towards success, and define success for yourself. Make those goals that are best for you, and take that imperfect action now. Because if you wait, you're gonna push it off another day. And when you do get to that day, you may not be fully ready, because there's no such thing as being fully ready. There is no perfect time. There is no perfect place. There is no perfect moment except for right now. Because right now is the only moment that you are guaranteed to have, right now. If you don't take advantage of right now and take that imperfect action now, then later may not come, or when later does come, you're gonna push it off to another later. Instead of going, right now is my moment. Right now, I have an opportunity. Right now, I can make the decision to take the imperfect action to make that imperfect change. Because remember, perfect isn't real, but you are, and what you want can be real and attainable if you make the momentum occur. But you have to be willing to take that action. There has been no one in history, no one in any type of amazing accomplishment, amazing feat that has been demolished. There has been no one that hasn't taken action to create that change. Whether it's picking up a book and reading one page, whether it's trying to climb Mount Everest, it takes one step. But after you take one step, then comes the second, then comes the third. Then that's how you get to the top. It doesn't have to be a perfect step. When you read, you don't have to be perfectly attentive. When you film a video, you don't have to be perfectly in frame. The video doesn't have to be perfect HD. You know what I'm saying? But you have to still create the video in order to have the video. You have to take the step in order to accomplish the hike. You have to read the page in order to read the whole book. You know what I'm saying? But the imperfect action is a requirement. The action and the fact that it's imperfect, that is a requirement to get to the end line, to get to the goal, to get to your dreams. So I'm telling you, this moment right now, once you're done with this video, you turn this off, whatever you have on that to-do list, or if you haven't created a to-do list, take a five-minute break. Take a five-minute moment to write down your goals, or let's say what I want to do, and then in the next 30 minutes, write one thing down and then just do it. Or you know what? Don't even write it down. Just verbalize it and go do it. I've been meaning to vacuum the floor. Go grab the vacuum. Do you know what I'm saying? Ah, man, those dishes in the sink. Go wash the dishes. They're not going to go anywhere. Oh, I wanted to read that book. Read one page. Put it by your nightstand. Make it accessible. Do these things. I'm telling you. You got a loved one that you know you've kind of fell out of contact with. As we get older, it becomes easier to not contact individuals. Give your mama a call. Say, I'm going to give her a quick ring. Talk to her for 3 minutes. You can even set a timer. And then if you don't actually have obligations to follow, maybe you'll go to 5 or 10. I'm telling you. And it's just like with health and fitness, with fitness specifically, nutrition, eating healthy is the exact same. You don't have to go full bore. I'm throwing everything out of my fridge and starting completely over. Trust me, I've done it. And that's how you regress and go back to how you used to be, but even worse. I remember when I first became quote unquote vegan, and I call myself a flexible vegan, but you know, I'm still eating dominantly plant-based. That is my focus. But what I found is when I created this ultimate urgent, like I gotta get rid of it all. Instead of just eating more plants and eating, being a little bit more conscious of my decisions and experiencing what's in my mouth and having more of a holistic approach with every meal, what I did is when I got burnt out, because burnout is inevitable if you choose to go that yin or yang, that complete one or the other black and white perspective, what happens is then you regress not just back to where you were, but probably before where you were. So not only I was meal prepping before, not only did I completely stop meal prepping, but I started going back to In-N-Out and stuff like that. So it was a complete regression. So you have to remind yourself that imperfect action, let's say you're eating a lot of fast food. Let's say every meal you have fast food. And you eat a drink of soda every meal. What if one meal, just one meal, or even one snack, you have a glass of water instead of the soda? Swap that out. And then the next day, keep that water, and then maybe instead of fries, you get a side salad. You know what I'm saying? Like, imperfect action. It doesn't have to, you can still have the hamburger on there. You can still have the cheese. You know what I'm saying? But if you take these small steps, if you make these small changes, these imperfect actions, if you say, you know what, I've been drinking every night. How about one night a week? Don't even stop completely drinking. Count how many drinks you have. Let's say you have 3. How about one night a week, you go to 2. You're gonna create that momentum to get the confidence. You're gonna get the confidence within you, and the want and the will and the drive will refire up, and you're gonna go, you know what? Nah, I want one. I want one this night, and then this night I'll have 2. And the next thing you know, you're having one day off, and then you're having 2 days off, and so on and so forth. It's a domino effect. But if you don't push the domino, the other dominoes never fall. So you have to push the domino to create the domino effect. And the push is the action. And there is no perfect push, so it's always imperfect action. Take imperfect action to reach your ultimate satisfaction. I'm telling you, right now, this is your moment. Turn this video off once I'm done. I'm about to be done here in a second. Once this video's over, turn it off, shut the computer down, put the phone down, and go take advantage of this moment with whatever task you know that you need to go. Whether it's go walk the dog around the block, whether it's go on a quick little run, whether it's maybe go eat a meal, but instead of having those fries, swap it out for an apple. Whatever that situation is, whether it's read that one page, whether it's call your mom or your dad, do that action now. Don't wait, don't hesitate. And take that imperfect action in this moment right now, because this moment right now is the only one that you own, that you control, and that you guarantee where it's gonna go, all right? So one more time, it's Taj Rocket, okay, Mr. Highly Motivated, here to get you motivated. We out here at Vacation Isle Park. I told y'all, episode number 43, I'm gonna help you get your mind free. We're gonna turn it up a couple degrees. Hey, I'll see y'all next time, though. Different location, same energetic motivation. And remember, this is your moment right now. It's the only one you're guaranteed to have. So take advantage of it. Take imperfect action. And I'll see y'all next time, baby. Holla.